Hey everyone, I'm going to show you how to do the wrap and turns for the Loom Knit Lizard Ridge pattern. Now this pattern is free on Ravelry. It is not my pattern, but just do a Google search for Loom Knit Lizard Ridge and you'll come up with this pattern. Print it off. I'm going to make this really short video. Go ahead and print it off. Now, one of the things I have to say is I do my wrap and turns differently. This pattern says to lift the loop off from the peg and hold it in the back and then wrap the peg around with a working yarn. I don't lift that yarn off. I don't lift that loop off. I just wrap it, and I'll show you exactly what I mean. And the part that we're going to be working on is this right here. Now, there's two rows where you do these back and forth. There's row 4 and row 5, and they're a little bit, row 4 and row 10, they're a little bit different, but right now I'm just going to show you row 4. I am using a bulky yarn. I'm obviously not making a dishcloth. I'm making a poncho. You can use this for a blanket or whatever. I'm using a KB 5/8 gauge loom. I'm using a number 5 weight yarn, and so this is a color changing yarn. And it just works out wonderfully with this pattern. So let's get started. So I'm following along in the pattern for row number 4, and I've gone ahead and I've wrap and turned my 12, or to peg 12, and then did my set of wrap and turns, and then I knit to peg 20 pegs forward from that last wrap and turn, and that's where I'm at right now. So I'll just show you how to do this. It'll make much more sense if you have the pattern and can follow along. So I have knitted out 20 pegs, okay? So this is my first wrap and turn, and this is where the directions say to lift this loop right here. I don't lift it, okay? Let me move in. I don't lift it. I just simply wrap the yarn around it just like that. And then I am e-wrapping because that's what works best with my loom and my yarn. Make sure you do a swatch on this because the first time I tried it, it was way too tight and it did not work. I tried it on a 3/8 loom with this yarn. It did not work. It was too tight. So I had to move up to a 5/8 gauge loom. So I'm knitting back 8 pegs. I just did this wrap and turn to reverse my direction and I'm going down 8 pegs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? So, this is where I'm at. I just knit 8. I did my wrap and turn and I knit 8. So now, I do another wrap and turn and I knit 7 back the opposite direction. Okay, here's my wrap and turn. Past that, that's our peg 8, wrap and turn. Now we're going to do 7 the opposite direction. Okay, let me push these down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and you know when to stop because you want to stop right for the peg after this one that has the two loops. And that just turns out to be 7. That peg right here, this is peg 7. This one is going to be another wrap and turn. Just wrap it around the front to back and then move on to your e-wrap. So according to the pattern here, we are now right here. Wrap and turn and knit 6. So the wrap and turn turns you the opposite direction. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, we know we need to wrap and turn this one because we have these two right there. So now we have 2 wrap and turns. Now we're going to go back the opposite direction. 5 wrap and turns as shown on the instructions. Let me push these down. Okay, we just did 5. We have our 2 wrap and turns right there. So now we're doing our third. So we want 3 wrap and turns on both the left side and the right side. And we're going to go in the middle here and we're just going to do 4 knits. And then that we end up right here. We have those 2 wrap and turns. We have this one that we wrap and turn on. And let's look at the directions. So we've just finished up this right here in the wrap and turns. We've gone down to wrap and turn 4. So we knitted 4, we've done our wrap and turn, and now it says to knit 20. So what I'm going to do is, there's my wrap and turn, and I'm just going to knit down 20 pegs to here. And then I'm going to do this whole wrap and turn 8, wrap and turn here, knit 8, wrap and turn, knit 7, wrap and turn, knit 6, wrap and turn, knit 5, knit, wrap and turn, knit 4. And then my last wrap and turn, I will just go down to the end and I will continue to follow the pattern. So I hope that helps. Thanks, everyone.